So if integrity is defined by what you do when no one is looking, then perhaps political principle is somewhat of a practical opposite, meaning it is what you stick to when everyone is looking. And in this new book, American Carnage by Tim Alberta, we are reminded about how so many who stake their reputation on principle caved to political convenience in this administration. Exhibit A has to be Paul Ryan, because moments like this became a staple of my coverage of this administration. Do you hear that? That's the silence from Mitch McConnell and Paul Ryan. Time and time again, this president would say provocative things and they would say nothing. Ryan would never take an invitation to defend any of his standing by, despite always casting himself as different, as putting principle before party. But when he took the speakership, insisting he would do it his way, his spine softened. Now that he's retired, he seems to be trying to recast his reticence to speak truth to power with this. We've gotten so numbed by it all, not in government, but where we live our lives, we have a responsibility to try and rebuild. Don't call a woman a horse face. Don't cheat on your wife. Don't cheat on anything. Be a good person. Set a good example. He never said anything like that about this president when he had the power to make a stand. Despite him saying he would never defend this personal perfidy of this president. And I say, forget about his remounting the moral high horse about this president's personal life. I don't care about his personal life. Let's stick to serious politics and policy and remember where Ryan stood while in office. Here he is on Trump's arguably inappropriate interactions with Jim Comey.
He's new at government, and so therefore I think that he's learning as he goes.
On Trump's Charlottesville both sides comment.
He's learning. I know his heart's in the right place.
And on the executive order banning Muslims.
The president has a responsibility to the security of this country. We need to pause and we need to make sure that the vetting standards are up to snuff so we can guarantee the safety and security of our country. That is what this does.
Did we? Because just 14 months before that, he was infuriated by the suggestion of the same type of ban. Proof.
What was proposed yesterday is not what this party stands for. And more importantly, it's not what this country stands for.
So what happened? I'll tell you what happens. With every collapse of character, the offender in politics often rationalizes the fall. Quote, I told myself I gotta have a relationship with this guy to help him get his mind right. Because I'm telling you, he didn't know anything about government. I wanted to scold him all the time. Yeah, but you didn't. You said nothing too often.
I've decided I'm not going to comment on the tweets of the day or the hour. I haven't seen them all, to be candid with you.
And when he did speak, he was meek. And when he acted, he was in this president's shadow. A 538 analysis shows Ryan voted in line with Trump's position 95.5% of the time. From the border wall to the Fugazi middle-class tax cuts that ballooned the deficit, so much for being a budget hawk, right? Ryan's signature issue. There are other examples in here of how those around this POTUS were once opposed and then became patsies. Mr. Spicer, Mr. Priebus, Mr. Mulvaney. Can you believe the man who now says you gotta let Trump be Trump is code for I'm scared, right? Mulvaney once said, we're not gonna let Donald Trump dismantle the Bill of Rights. But I focus on Paul Ryan, why? Because he could well have a second act in politics and he could look good to the reasonable right and even some in the center. But he's gonna have to own that he was just like the rest of them, not the best of them. He was given a chance to do what he said he would do. All the things that made so many smile when he spoke, seeing in him a hope for a better politics, principle before party, progress before patronage. But when he had the power to be different as speaker, he was painfully the same. Alberta writes that Ryan saw retirement as an escape hatch. Maybe an escape from Trump or from politics, but not from reality. This period that we're all living together right now is going to be remembered for a long time, and people will be counted what they stood for, what they stood against, and absolutely those who stood still.